Just to get this thing rolling. I'm not working very good at the moment. Ah! Okay. Hold on. All right, that should be better. All right, so we got a +2 charge on the inside. We got a +3 charge on the outside. What that means is that I have to have twice as many lines coming from this that strike than strike the outside. So I'm going to use 8. So now I can divide 8 by 2 and get 4. And then now I've got 4 more. All right, and so this plate's going to receive 4. So I draw that going in, I draw that going in, I draw that going in, I draw that going in. Now, it satisfied all my original requirements. Question is, what happens to the remaining lines? What's interesting is they have to go straight out. They have no other choices, so they follow this rule. This simulates the fact that the charges would move to the inside to cancel the charge, would suddenly appear on the outside. The positive charge would float out to the outside as a negative would shield the inside. All right, but that's basically the way that would work. Right. All right, so find the expression for Gauss's law to find the magnitude of the electric field between the two spheres, the distance r between the inner sphere and the center of the inner sphere. So here we're going to draw the sphere inside. Oh, I need a pen. Here we're going to draw the sphere inside, distance r from the middle. It's symmetric, so I end up going integral e dot dA equals q enclosed over e naught. Then, of course, this always becomes EA equals Q enclosed over E naught. Therefore, the electric field is equal to 4 pi r squared, the area, surface area of the object I'm choosing to surround my inner thing with, which is equal to charge enclosed, which in this case is 2Q over E naught. So the electric field would have to be 2Q over 4 pi r squared e naught, and that's how you solve that problem. Straight Gauss's law, nothing fancy there at all. Calculate the potential difference between the two spheres. So I bring out the electric field, this piece of cake. We go voltage equals negative integral of the electric field dr. Since they want to know between the outer and inner shells, that's between. And here's the interesting, they didn't say which one to which one, so I could put either one on the top and bottom. Doesn't matter to you, so you could do R on the top, 3R on the bottom, because the difference between the two plates doesn't actually tell us which plate to which plate. Okay, so electric field's right over here. So it becomes the negative integral of R, 3R. You just solve electric field between the two, which is going to be Q over 2, I got rid of the 2 divided by 4 simply by dividing that out. I've got a pi, I've got an E naught, those are all constants, and I got R to the negative 2, which is really what I'm going to take the integral of. Raise the power by 1, divide the power I get, R to the negative 1, Q over 2 pi E naught. The negatives cancel out, because if I divide by negative power I get, divided by the power, but divided by that power, negative times negative needs to be a positive. And this becomes R to 3R. Remember, this R is technically on the bottom, so the answer would be something like Q over, let's go on right there. Right. 2 times pi E naught 3R, and again, we should probably put the 2 and the 3 together, over Q minus Q over 2 pi E naught R. Real quickly, this gives me 1/6 Q over pi E naught R minus, of course, 1/2 Q pi E naught R. This would be 3/6 when I do a common denominator, so it could be 2/6. So the actual answer would be something like 1 over 3 pi E naught. All right, but again, all I did, now that I have the electric field, I then went and did use this formula to find the voltage, right? It says, well, I just tell you from where to where. If it doesn't tell you from where to where, you go from infinity, but this says between the two spheres, so I go to the outer sphere to the inner sphere. And again, since it didn't say where I start and where I finish, I can start at either sphere. would be fine. Last question is a fairly interesting one. It says something about putting a wire between the two. We spent some time talking about that, but in every case we talked about before, when we connected the two, they were equal-sized shapes. We certainly can't say that here. In fact, one surrounding the other one, which seems like a strange arrangement. So first thing I want to do is I want to calculate the total charge. If we got negative Q on the outside, 2Q on the inside, then the negative Q would flow this way. I'd still have a plus Q here, right? And I'd have no Q on the outside. Now, what does the charge want to do? It's conducting, so it can do whatever it wants to. What does it want to do? It wants to spread out as far apart as it can. So we know in conductors, it always goes to the outside as far as it could possibly go. So we would say simply the inner shell would have zero charge, and the outer shell would have all the charge, which happens to be 1Q. You can put a plus in front of it if you like. And that would be the answer, right? Because again, all that's trying to happen here is that the charge is get as far apart as it possibly can if it's conducting. Since it's conducting, it's going to get as far apart as it can, and that would be on the outer shell as far apart as it could possibly be.